Hey everyone, this is Nate Storr with Bright Agritech, and we're really excited today to talk about Bato buckets. As you know, towers are great for herbs, for greens, for those short statured crops. They're one of the best ways in the world to grow those, but if you're talking about vining crops, things like tomatoes, hops, cucumbers, eggplant, larger statured crops, you really need to be using a different technique, and that's why we're talking about Bato buckets today. So now we're going to hand this off to Ruben. He's going to show you guys how to set these systems up. If you have any questions, make sure that you leave them in the comment section below.
Hey, this is Ruben with Bright Agritech, and today we're going to show you how to build an 8-bucket Bato bucket system. Now, the only thing we don't show you in this video is how to build the table itself, which what we did is we took a 2x8 sheet of melamine, put it on some 2x4s, and cut down the legs on this side so our drainage line would drain to the reservoir. So let's get started. The things you're going to need for this system is 8 buckets, and they should come with 8 drain fittings. A reservoir of your liking, which we ended up switching out to a 15-gallon white reservoir. A pump. About 20 feet of half-inch poly or vinyl tubing. A roll of quarter-inch poly tubing. A 10-foot stick of 1 1/2-inch PVC tubing with an elbow and end cap. You'll need a half-inch drain valve. And about 16 2-gallon drip emitters, 2 pipe clamps, and some zip ties. Oh, and some 2-inch binder clips. So now what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to cut your PVC down to 8 feet, leaving a couple extra inches so you can fit your end cap and your elbow on the ends. Make sure your PVC fits on the table. Once we know it fits, we'll grab our first Bato bucket. So you're going to place your Bato bucket near the edge of the table. Once you find a good spot, grab a marker and add a mark. From there, we'll grab a tape measure and we'll measure 1 foot and we'll add 7 more marks. Now you're going to want to grab a drill and a 3/4 to 1 inch hole saw and drill out those 8 marks. Next, you're going to want to PVC cement and prime your end cap and elbow, making sure that all your holes are facing up when you put on the elbow. Next, we're going to set all our buckets on the system. Then what we'll do is we'll drill out a couple holes on each side to put some zip ties to make sure that our drain line stays in place. You can also use 1 1/2-inch conduit clamping instead of zip ties. Next, we're going to take our half-inch vinyl tubing, clamping it down with binder clips to each bucket. Once you have your irrigation line set out, we're going to take an 1/8-inch drill bit and drill out 16 holes on each side of the binder clips. These holes are where we will be placing our 2-gallon drip emitters. Next, we'll take the end of our irrigation line, cut it, and add on a release valve. This is good for if you ever want to drain your reservoir or flush your system. Now let's take the 1/4-inch poly tubing and cut out 16 pieces at 5 inches. These pieces will center our irrigation so it drips directly over our plants. Next, we'll clamp down our pump to the start of our irrigation line. Now that we have all the pieces together, it's time to test out the system. We want to do this before we set any media in so we can make sure it works. Once we know our system is working, it is time to fill up each bucket with the media of your liking. What we went with was perlite and clay pebbles. The first thing you're going to want to do is add clay pebbles to the bottom. This will act as a filter so none of the perlite ends up clogging the drain. Next, add in your perlite, making sure you get close but not to the top, because we're going to add one more layer, and this will be of clay pebbles so our perlite doesn't end up blowing around from the wind. Awesome. So that's pretty much it. So if you have any questions or anything, please let us know. Most of this stuff now is sold on our store, so there should be a link above me that will take you there. And if you're interested in us showing you how to build a table like this, please leave a comment. And as always, please subscribe, and thanks for watching.